Hi, welcome to ACE Teachers Online, a series of online tutorials for students. My name's Daniel, and today we'll be doing a question on standard solutions and dilutions. What is a standard solution? Well, a standard solution is a solution of an accurately known concentration. We usually use them in things like titrations, spectrophotometry, and chemical analysis. In short, we make these solutions by dissolving a carefully weighed substance in a volumetric flask so that we have its accurately known number of moles, volume, and therefore concentration. However, it's important to know that not all substances can be used to make a standard solution, in particular a primary standard as I just described. In fact, they have to fit a number of criteria. Well, first of all, it has to be water soluble because deionized water is the main solvent used when making standard solutions. It also has to be high purity, obviously. Also, it has to have a definite and fixed chemical formula so that we can accurately calculate its molar mass. And it also has to be stable in air so that it doesn't react with oxygen or absorb any water from the air, which could change its molar mass. Finally, it should have a high molecular weight to minimize any percentage error when we're weighing the substance. With your volumetric flask, this is a highly accurate piece of equipment that dispenses a single predetermined volume of solution. And we usually use these to make our standard solutions. To use our volumetric flask, we usually use a beaker of deionized water and fill most of it until we're close to the mark. Once we're close to it, we'll use a clean pipette to slowly add water drop by drop until the meniscus is in line with the gradation mark. Remember, we're looking for the bottom of the meniscus to be in line with the mark. In order to avoid any parallax error, we should put the volumetric flask on a bench and crouch down until your eyes are in level with the mark. After this, if everything's in line, we can put the stopper on and invert it 10 to 15 times to homogenize the mixture. Don't worry if the meniscus is slightly lower than the mark after this, it's just because the solution is stuck on the walls of the flask. If you've done everything perfectly and accurately and carefully, you should be left with a perfect solution. Now onto dilutions. So a dilution is the addition of more solvent, usually water, to a solution in order to reduce the overall concentration of solute dissolved. It's important to know that dilutions can only reduce the concentration in a solution. This is important practically when we're doing it in a lab, because it's much harder to go back to a higher concentration once you've diluted something. So to calculate the new concentration of a diluted solution, we'll use a new formula, C1V1 equals C2V2. In order to make sense of this, imagine we've dissolved some sodium chloride into a beaker of water. Now from previous weeks, we know we can calculate the number of moles of sodium chloride by N equals C1V1. C1V1 being the initial concentration and volumes of the solution. Now, if we perform a dilution and add some water, we've obviously changed the concentration and volume of the solution, becoming C2 and V2. Now, by the same N equals CV formula, we know that the number of moles of sodium chloride in this solution is C2 times V2. But clearly, the number of moles of sodium chloride hasn't changed when we've performed this dilution. So therefore, we can say that C1 times V1 equals C2 times V2, giving us our formula. So this question is pretty clearly set out, so we can work through it chronologically. First of all, we'll calculate how many moles of sodium carbonate we have, using 5.4 grams over the molecular weight of sodium carbonate, and that gives us 0.050948 moles. Now, to calculate the concentration in the 100 ml flask, we'll use C equals N over V. Here, we've got N being the moles, and V being our 100 ml volumetric flask, and that gives us 0.509 molar concentration. So that's the first part of the question done. Now, onto the dilution. Here we're going to use our new formula, C1V1 equals C2V2. Here, we've rearranged the equation to get C2 as our subject because that's what we're trying to find out. So we have C2 equals C1 V1 over V2. In this case, C1 is what we just calculated, V1 is the 20 mils he takes out, and V2 is the 50 mil volumetric flask. So plugging all these numbers in, we get 0.204 molar as the second concentration of the diluted solution. To summarize, we've gone over standard solutions and how to make them, volumetric flasks and how to accurately use them, and finally dilutions and how to calculate their final concentrations.
Thanks for watching this video. For more information, look at our website down below and keep tuned for more ACE Teachers Online.